Akoze ebikulu kati omwana wange agenda kufumbirwa olunaku n'olwaleero kati neebaza Katonda kubanga yakikoze ekyo kiba mu mukisa gwa Katonda mukono gwe tegenepaye akoledde ebikulu era olwaleero tetujje tusanyuka kuba mukama akoledde ono mwana w'amanyiraze e Joyce Kasozi tufumbirwa ate tetunoba era nakimugamba tewali kunoba naye katusabe kubanga twebaza mukama namusabanga ekigambo ekyo naye nga nokudde ku lunaku
mukama
yagamba nti alinsaba kunkunaku lijjo nja kukugulirawo mukama yeebaza Jeriini okujja nafukamira mu maaso gange nanga nti maama ngenda kufuna naye mukama era nsanyukidde abantu bonna abazze okuwa okusa omukolo gaffe ekitiibwa neebaza Katonda olw'erinnya ly'eddungu lwa Yesu Kristo mukama
waffe
okubeerawo kati kino kyekyenkya kye tugenda okulya okuva enkya tugenda okulya buli musanyu gereere kubanga kyekyakitukisuubira naye kikoleddwa olw'erinnya lya Katonda.
Because Tendo has to drive us to the...
Tendo is outside. Amen.
Let God lead us today and let everything be okay. We love you, Jeremy.
So you have to enjoy. Thank you
for this day. This day has come today, Jerin. We pray for you a good marriage. You pray to God. What that's what you want to know, that pray to your God. The first thing, serve your husband. Let God bless you in your marriage and get children, a lot of them. Thank you. Bye.
Hello, Jerin. Well done. You've made it. Hey. Everybody thought you would make it. Look at you now. And you got me out of London. You are good.
What's your name?
Josephine.
Joyce Kasozi.
And enjoy the day.
I know.
Make a promise to enjoy the day.
Bring him here?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Sorry.
The best man.
Okay.
Yeah, the best man can come here.
Okay. So this is the pastor I was talking about.
Yes, we did.
Smile and smile.
It's all good now. It's all good. You look gorgeous, by the way. You look absolutely gorgeous.
She's a beautiful girl.
She is.
I believe you're not here.
I just want to get done with this.
Okay, it's going to be done in very shortly, so let's relax.
But you know, the day is here.
Okay.
And we don't want to screw it.
Be in the day. Just be in the day. It's all good.
I'm talking.
It's okay. So here's what's going to happen now.
Yes.
Oh, a few more guests coming. Come on down. Come on down.
Go slow.
Yeah. So why don't you just stay here, sweetie? Stay here.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, there we go. Okay, so here's the best man.
Let's just wait.
Maid of honor. So, you guys? You?
Yes, you.
Okay, great, perfect. Remember, you're staying on the right side. Yes, exactly. So, then you guys are going to walk down.
Mm-hmm. I'll switch to a different song. Jerin, is there a song you want?
Yeah, whatever. All I want to do is just get done with this. Okay. So you two will, I'll switch the song and you say, okay, we're ready for the wedding to begin.
Yeah.
You two will walk down.
No, I leave her on the other side. But...
Yeah, and then you're going to, so then you will stand on that side.
Wait,
yeah, we're talking.
No, I just use an eyebrow.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Giving everything I've got, taking every second loss. Success just ain't enough. You won't have to be in me. Don't want to pretend cause I need to.
Yeah, come on in, there's seats. Come on in. Okay, everybody, we are ready for a wedding. Who's ready for a wedding? Say yeah. You're ready for a wedding. Did you guys say you're ready for a wedding, everybody? Okay. So, I'm going to pick a processional song. Does anyone have a favorite? Ooh, pastor. Where's the pastor? Do you have a favorite processional song? I need advice. Well, he's up there. All right. It's going to be random, the random pick. So, if everyone can get seated, and you guys, the bridal party will be kind of just coming right through the middle here. And let's see what happens. Random pick. Let's see what happens. Not the one. Okay. So if the yes man. Okay, are we ready for the bride? Yes, we are ready for the bride. Come on down.
This woman to this man. Okay, Richard, so if you would please bring the bride, and why don't you have a seat, Mom? Okay. Oh, it, either side is okay. We're going loose on the sides thing. Okay.
Mom?
Okay. Jerry, why don't you give your flowers to your maid of honor there? Okay. Beautiful. So welcome, everyone, to the wedding of Jerry Nandawula and Tim Tricarco. Tom. But thank you, Tim. Yeah. Oh, my gosh. And this is being recorded. Awesome. I was so worried about the last name. I got the first name wrong. Awesome. Okay. Well, I'm embarrassed to say it. So my name's Linda Manning. Jerrine and I met 16 years ago when she became a nanny for my kids, who are here today to celebrate her wedding. So, on behalf of Jerrine and Tom, I would like to thank you all for being here this afternoon, for taking the time and making the journey, and for all the effort that it takes, not only to be part of this day, but to be part of each other's lives. Jerrine and Tom have invited you here to this beautiful place to share their love with you. So you can stay standing if you want, but you could also feel free to sit down. I'll be getting you standing up again in a few minutes. So, beautiful. So as you guys know, every relationship is unique. And one thing holds true though, for love to exist between two people, each person must be open and vulnerable and willing to both give and receive love. So each of us has the choice every day to dedicate ourselves to one another or to withhold love and caring. Jerrine and Tom, as you walk through the ups and downs of life, I hope that you will always choose to give love, even when it's challenging. And if you ask couples with good relationships what they like most about their partners, many will say that when they're with that person, they don't have to pretend to be anything other than who they are. They're able to relax and express all of themselves without fear of being judged or rejected. And there's room in the relationship for both of them to be unique individuals, and I think it is safe to say that these two are unique individuals. Absolutely. So Tom and Jerrine, may you always experience the freedom that comes from being known and loved unconditionally and knowing that you have each other's backs. So as you know, both the bride and the groom have been married before and they both lost their spouses. So we're going to, at this time, take a moment to honor the loved ones who can't be here today. So we're going to go right over here. So we're going to, Tom, hopefully you know how to use this kind of lighter. I'm going to have you light this candle in honor of your late wife. There we go. And Jerrine is going to light another candle in honor of her late husband. You have to, pushed it. It's two parts, yeah. There you go. Tom, you can help your bride. Yeah. Right, try it again. Oh. There we go. Ready? Jerrine, you hold my hand. And then the two of them, Tom, I'm going to let you be the lead, are going to be lighting a third candle together because this is really about their future together. And so we honor the past, but we also acknowledge that this is a new day with a new future together. And that is what the beautiful gold candle symbolizes. Okay. So at this point, I would love to invite the pastor up. Pastor Awori is going to say a few words and give them a blessing. Pastor.
Thank you. What a blessing. We give God all the praise and the glory tonight. For me, this is not just a wedding celebration. It is personal because Jerrine is my sister. And I honor God for, I have a great family here, friends, and above all, our mother's here. And we thank God that she was able to come and experience this tonight. And it is a joy that engulfs the mother's heart, knowing that the daughter is going to make a covenant, a lifetime covenant. And there is nothing that has brought joy in our mother's heart like seeing the two lovebirds say to each other, I love you no matter what. And I wanted to talk about just a little bit. You know, we're not going to preach tonight. It's just there's a part of the scripture that I want to read over here. In the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 13, I'm going to read from verse 4. It says, love endures with patience and scrutiny. Love is kind and thoughtful, and it is not jealous or envious. Love does not brag, and it is not proud or arrogant. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not provoked, nor overly sensitive, and easily angered. It does not take into account a wrong endured. It does not rejoice at injustice, but rejoices with the truth when right and truth prevail. Love bears all things, regardless of what comes, believes all things, looking for the best in each other, hope all things, remaining steadfast during difficult times, endures all things without weakening. Love never fails. It never fades nor ends. Now, there are different kind of loves, but this kind of love, it never fails. Let's say we put five different kind of loves, and then you choose this kind of love, you're never going to fail. Amen. No matter what.
Amen.
May God richly bless you. Let's pray.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, we thank you tonight. We honor you, for there is no God like you. The threefold cords can never easily be broken. You are the third cord. Together, Lord, bind them together for everlasting love. Till death do them apart. We honor you, Lord, tonight as family and friends have gathered here tonight. I invoke the presence of the Holy Spirit to come sit on us. Sit on us until we get it all right. Let your name be glorified. Let you be honored. I call on the blessings of Isaac, Jacob, and Abraham, and the blessings of our parents to gather in here tonight as we send them off with this kind of love. Let your grace and your mercy take them through all difficulties and let them come out and say, yes, God has given us the victory at the end of it all. We bless your name. We glorify you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
Who feels inspired right now?
Amen.
I feel inspired.
Amen.
So, Jereen and Tom would like to invite you to participate in their wedding. So anyone who right now will declare your support for them, your love for them, your friendship for them, as they go through their marriage, please stand up. Offer your love and support to this couple. Sending it out to each of them. Can you guys feel the love?
Yes.
Let's let yourself receive it, Jereen and Tom. Feel the love of all these beautiful people around you. Okay. All right, you can be seated again. So I loved what Pastor read, and I'm going to read a poem from Cahil Gibran. I can't say his name either. Which is it's called On Marriage. So love one another, but make not a bond of love. Let it rather be a moving sea between the shores of your souls. Fill each other's cup, but drink not from one cup. Give one another of your bread, but eat not from the same loaf. Sing and dance together and be joyous, but let each one of you be alone. Even as the strings of a lute are alone, though they quiver with the same music. Give your hearts, but not into each other's keeping, for only the hand of life can contain your hearts. And stand together, yet not too near together, for the pillars of the temple stand apart, and the oak and the cypress tree grow not in each other's shadow. So, the ceremony that we are experiencing right now is not magic. It will not create a relationship that does not already exist. Tom and Jereen have made many commitments to each other, both large and small, since they first met. What we're celebrating today is not the beginning of a marriage, but a marriage already in progress. And this ceremony is a symbol of how far they have come together, and a symbol of the promises that they will continue to make to each other throughout their lives together. So look at one another and remember this moment in time. So before this moment, you've been many things to one another, friend, fiancé, but now you shall say a few words that take you across a threshold of life, and things will never be quite the same between you, for after these vows, you will say to this world, this is my husband and this is my wife. Nothing is easier than standing here, although I'm not actually sure that's true. Sometimes some things are easier than standing here and saying these words. But nothing is more difficult than living with them day to day. When you love someone, you don't love them all the time in exactly the same way. That is impossible. Yet, that's what most of us expect. We forget the ebb and flow of life and of love and of relationships. But in love, as in life, the only stability is in change, in growth, and in freedom. Therefore, what you promise today must be renewed and reaffirmed tomorrow and all the tomorrows to come. So, is there a few words that you would like to say to Jereen at this time, Tom?
Yes. Yes, there are. We were fortunate in that the very first time we met, we instantly had a camaraderie that we could both sense, and it led to our expansion of that camaraderie into the love that we are feeling for each other right now. Jereen, you are stunningly beautiful. You have the sweetest heart that I've ever known. You are vivacious.
Yep.
And you sometimes say you're crazy. But I always correct you in saying, no, it's a good kind of crazy.
Yes.
It's a fun kind of crazy. And it's the kind of crazy I don't want to be without.
Now that is a good maid of honor, right? Jereen, is there anything that you would like to say?
Tom, the first day I met you, I knew you were going to be my husband. And that drive from Manhattan to New Jersey, oh God, it was the most beautiful drive ever. And you told me you love me before I even said that. But I knew I was going to marry you anyway.
So, having considered all of these things, Tom, do you promise to do your very best each day to create a loving, healthy, and happy marriage?
I do.
And Jereen, do you promise to do your very best each day to create a loving, healthy, and happy marriage?
I do.
Okay. So, no one but you can declare yourselves married, although legally I will help out on that. You have begun it here today in speaking your vows and your commitments before your family and your friends, and you will do it again in the days and years to come, standing by each other, sharing the highs and lows of life. So bless this marriage, oh God, as they begin their journey down the road of life together. We don't know what lies ahead, for the road turns and bends, but help them to make the best of whatever comes their way. Help them to continue to enjoy each other as they did when they first met. Help them to realize that nothing and no one is perfect, and to look for the good in all things and all people, including themselves. Help them to respect each other's likes and dislikes, opinions and beliefs, hopes and dreams and fears, even when they don't understand them. And help them to learn from each other. Help them to grow mentally, emotionally, and spiritually. Help them to realize that no matter what happens to them, they will hold on to each other and know that things have a way of working out for the good. And I know Jereen knows that. She believes in the good. But most of all, dear God, help them to keep lit the torch of love that they now share, so that by their loving example, they may pass on the light of love forever. Amen.
Amen.
So my hope for you is this, that may you have many years to delight in each other's company and to love and be loved by the friends and family who have come here today to support you, and many new ones that you may meet along the way. May you make a home together that is at once sheltering and welcoming. May you each do meaningful, productive work in the world and learn from your failures and grow from your accomplishments. May life's challenges be met together with courage and optimism. And may your days be filled with laughter, imagination, trust, friendship, and love. So it is now my honor and delight to declare you husband and wife. You may kiss each other. So I present to you Jereen and Tom Tricarico. Okay.
We need some more music, I think. Who knows who to dance to? What do you think?
Okay, there are maps on the table that show you where to park in Concord Center. The address is 74 Walden Street. 74 Walden Street. You can put in your GPS in Concord. 74 Walden Street is where the reception will be. And there's lots of different parking lots around Concord Center, so you may want to grab a map so you can find some parking. Okay, so meet us all at the reception or hang out and enjoy and celebrate with the bride and the groom.
Good night.
Thank you.
our seats. I want to invite Pastor Worry to come and bless this function. Just bless the function, pray for the food, and then we'll do something else. What a blessing tonight as we celebrate. To us, some she's our daughter and our son. To others, friends. To others, brothers and sisters. It's a real mega blessing tonight. So let everybody settle in as we welcome the presence of God in this place. It all starts with God and ends with God. So let's pray. Heavenly Father, we bless your name. We honor you, for there is no God beside you. We dedicate tonight in your hands. Would you break every barrier? Let your presence sit in this place and lead us according to your will. Lord, we thank you. We glorify your name as we celebrate tonight with your presence in this place. Let it permeate every room and every spot for the glory of your name. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we pray and everybody say, amen. God bless you.
Thank you very much, Pastor. Toyota Corolla, MA6PF 952, you'll be told in the next 2 minutes. So please go and take your vehicle. The other thing is that if you know you parked in the driveway, it can lead to shutting down of this wedding. So please go and attend to your vehicle and get another parking. Ladies and gentlemen, as we settle down, I want to welcome you once again. And before we do anything else, Mlangira Simba is going to serenade us just to set the mood for this wedding, so that we settle down and then we enjoy the evening. Simba. Number 2 line, 1-1. bajja tusunga kyenkyogedde mu Luganda baleme kuwulira webale nnyo webalire ddala tugumemu 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 katono
Thank you. Well, the game's beginning.
Extraordinary, and we are so very happy to have all of you here to share our day.
appropriate to pass out the champagne bottles around the room, and everyone can share a glass of champagne with us.
That's it? Wow. Okay, who has the champagne bottles? We need to pop some champagne, and that will be it. And then we'll cut cake. Yeah. I'll be with you shortly. Who has the champagne bottles? Okay, as they prepare the champagne bottles, share money.
Jareen through her husband. And 11 years ago, Jareen was my maid of honor. So I'm so glad I'm returning the favor now on her wedding to be the matron of honor. I'm going to say a few words about Jareen. What you see is what you get. Jareen right here, one, you know, main thing I know personally, what I know about Jareen, she's loyal. Jareen is loyal. And you know, this whole time I've known Jareen, if anyone, you know, says something, Jareen will step in and she's like, no, you cannot. Even when I'm with her and we're trying to talk about somebody else, Jareen will tell me, no, I don't talk about people. So this girl right here, yeah, she keeps, you know, reminding us. Those of you who know Jareen, I'm sure you can testify that she's a loyal friend. She is. I am honored to be at her wedding today as her matron of honor. She did on my wedding in 2011. Jareen, if you ever need anything from me, it doesn't matter what time it is. Just know that you can reach out to me and I will always be there for you. And I'm going to say a few words about our groom, Tom. I'm going to say something about Tom. Before Tom proposed to Jareen, he actually told me. He came to me and he's like, Barbara, I want to tell you something. I want to propose to Jareen, but I don't want her to know it. And this was 2020. And we were at Tom's place in 2020. And one thing I can tell you, Jareen, you're in good hands. He's a natural. Me and my husband, we were at Tom's place in New Jersey. Tom woke up so early. He made breakfast for us. He woke us up to eat. And then after, he left as we were eating breakfast. He went and bought salmon fish and green beans. And I've convinced myself that I don't like green beans. I don't eat them because, you know, they don't taste good.
Please come on, speak to us. But now, what do you want to do? I was looking for you. I was looking for you.
now I'm over here is my mom. So that equals Yerin is my sister. We are so delighted to be a part of this. Today is Yerin and Tom's day. We don't want to take a lot of your speeches, but we thank the Almighty God who has made it possible for you to attain that level of living today. And we also would like to sincerely thank all the organizers, because just as an individual, there's no way this would be pulled out together. So on behalf of my mom, Mama Nalongo, I would again like to thank all of you. God bless.
Okay, round of applause for Mama Narongo and the family. Because if it wasn't for Mama Narongo, which family am I going to? If it wasn't for Mama Narongo, we would not be here.
Ni mukama natusobozesa ne tukawa ne mama naddako awo
Angela. Let's have Angela come down the ramps from those speeches. Yes. way.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. From Mars.
I'm gonna go. Thank you. Yeah.